I'm Matt Spiegel from 670 The Score. I love great players. And the other night, after a dispiriting Cubs loss, believe it or not, I watched the highlight reel of Connor Bedard in his first preseason game. And my goodness, the skills just jump off the screen anytime you get to see him. We happen to have a Blackhawks pre- and post-game host right here, Joe Brand.
Hi.
How good is Connor Bedard going to be from the get-go, and how good might the Blackhawks be?
Look, even I'm wondering if I need to pump the brakes a little bit on this kid, but every time he's faced with a different challenge, not only does he succeed, he's one of the best guys out on the ice. Going into World Juniors the first time, he breaks Wayne Gretzky's record. Following year, he shatters the record with 23 points in a short amount of games. All right, first game in a Blackhawks sweater, hat trick. First game in a preseason game, some NHL competition. He gets two assists for the Hawks, only two goals, including the game winner. He's making casual fans understand how much he stands among the rest. He's the best guy on the ice in his first preseason game. We're going to get another glimpse of him tonight on Sunday night against the Detroit Red Wings. But it's almost Kane-esque, and there are other people that are already saying he could be better than Kane.
I think, the best thing that you said just now was the fact that he makes casual fans understand. Even if you don't watch hockey, like in a passerby kind of situation, you watch him and you get it within 5 minutes of why he's so special. And we talk about expectations. I don't know if the Blackhawks are going to be any good in terms of record-wise. I do expect him to win Rookie of the Year, though, and to dazzle all season long and keep you interested in a Blackhawks team, even if it is well under 500.
And carries himself like a 10-year veteran.
Yes.
18 years old. I didn't sound like that when I was 18 years old. 18 years old.
I don't sound like that now.
Right.
I could have gone pro at Tetris.
Look, he is the hope right now, I think, for all of Chicago sports. So you and I, leading up to the draft lottery, I'd see Joe in the hallway at WGN Radio. Man, that would really, really be awesome if they land this top pick. And Joe, I'm like, this kind of changes everything. And when it happened, it was a huge moment for the franchise, obviously. Again, Rec, to your point, I don't know exactly what they're going to look like fully as a team, but there will be major interest in this team because of Connor Bedard throughout the entire season.
And that's the thing. They were competitive last year, and I say competitive on a game-to-game basis.
Yes.
The head coach, Luke Richardson, is doing a fantastic job of getting a roster that wasn't supposed to win in a position to potentially win every game last year. There were like six or seven games that were kind of out the window. That was the third worst record in the NHL. That's what that head coach was able to do.
So they've got a foundation now for him to slide into.
And that is the best thing, I think, going forward for this team, is Kyle Davidson, the general manager, is being very patient with all of this. He's not going to accelerate the rebound.
A lot of veterans around him, too, which I like. You saw him on the bench.
Different veterans, too.
With Hall.
Back to Bedard, though. Come on.
I'm sorry.
Here's
the thing. Don't distract me from my steak.
But no, exactly. But for the casual fans and for the rest of us, I think what I love so much about him is that he is an artist, but it's necessary artistry.
Exactly.
It's like when Barry Sanders would make a crazy fun move because he had to. Or when Patrick Kane would do the same thing. So having that level of skill and artistry in town is going to be so fun.
His stats last year, 71 goals, 71 assists. It's not just the scoring ability. It's the surveying the ice, what's my best opportunity right here to create a goal, not to score it, not to help it, to create a
goal. I'm old enough to remember when Gretzky debuted and would just hang out behind the net before they change the rules and dominate the game, change the game. This kid has that level of talent.
So can I make a statement and you can tell me whether it's bold or not?
Tightly.
Listen, the Blackhawks are going to be way more entertaining to watch, regardless if they don't have a better record than the Bulls.
Oh, yeah, of course.
They're going to be more entertaining to watch.
I think that's true.
Bulls are stuck in the middle.
Yeah. Thanks, Marshall.
I'm just letting you know.
Man,
stick to Bedard here.
This is supposed to be a positive segment.
We had 4 minutes where we sat in glory and positivity.
There's no Bulls here.
We'll come back and talk about the MLB playoffs. Bulls. Some rule changes that we would consider for these playoffs. Yeah. That's